بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم أما بعد. In this lesson we're going to cover الدرس العاشر, the 10th lesson. And the main concept that is going to be taught in this lesson is the فعل مضارع. So far we already know that the فعل, which is the verb, الفعل, which is the verb, is divided into three types. We have الماضي, which is the past tense verb. And then we have al-mudari', which is the discussion of today's lesson, present and future tense. And we have al-amr. Al-amr is the command form. So with the madi, we mentioned that if it is three-lettered, then we have three possible scales. It can either be on fa'ala, or fa'ila, or fa'ula. These are the only three possibilities that we have. The fa and the lam remain with the fatha. It's just the ayn kalima which has a fatha sometimes, a kasra sometimes, a dhamma sometimes. But it's not going to come out of these three scales. These are the only three possible scales that we have for the three-lettered past tense verb. So if we give some examples, for fa'ala, we have fataha. Fataha is on the same scale as fa'ala. Likewise, we have خرج, and we have ضرب. These are all on the same scale as فعل. For فعل we have علم and حاسب. طيب, فتح means to open, خرج means to leave, ضرب means to hit, علم means to know, حاسب means to assume. فعل كارما and شاروفا and so on. كارما means to be generous. This is something that we've covered already. So we have فعل 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 for the فعل الماضي. In this lesson we're going to learn how to construct the فعل مضارع. And the أمر is the command form. This is going to be taught in a later lesson. So our focus is how do we construct, how do we create the مضارع. طيب, with the مضارع we're going to learn how to create the مضارع in four steps. Step number one is we have to add one of four letters. One of four letters at the start of the word. So we take the fi'l madi, we bring it here, and then we have to start with one of these four. It has to start with one of these four. Hamza, Noon, Ya, or Ta. And these can easily be memorized in an acronym, which is Anaitu. Anaitu is a past tense verb. It's a fi'l madi. It means I took my time. طيب, so Hamza, Noon, Ya, Ta, this acronym, you can memorize it because it covers the four letters. And these four letters are called أحرف, أحرف, أحرف المضارعتي, أحرف المضارعتي. أحرف المضارع are these four letters which are added at the start of the fi'l mudari'. There is no fi'l mudari' except that it starts with one of these four letters. How do you know which one it is that you need to choose? Well, they all have meanings. So Hamza, this Hamza at the start indicates Ana. Hamza indicates Ana. So Ana Adhabu, I am going. The Noon indicates Nahnu. So Nahnu Nadhabu, we are going. The Ya is used for third person. It's for the third person in general. Ya is for third person. Al-Ghaib. Yadhhabu, Yadhhabani. He went, the two of them went. So one, two, three, more. Yani, if it's third person, you're going to use Ya. And then the Ta comes for second person. Generally, the Ta comes for second person. Anta tadhhabu, tadhhabani, tadhhabuna, tadhhabina. So second person generally, and also third person feminine. So with here, the third person, it covers all third person except for third person feminine, singular. We don't use the ya. For third person, singular, feminine, we use the ta instead. Tadhhabu, for example, means she went. She went. So this is third person singular feminine, she went. طيب, so the The point here, we're not trying to memorize everything right now. What we're trying to learn here is the first step, and that is we need to add Hamza, Noon, Ya, or Ta. One of these letters, not all of them, just one. Which one depends on the meaning that you want to express. So let's start with Fa'ala. Let's say we have Fa'ala. We want to apply step one. Yes, let's add Ya. Ya. So Ya, and then we have Fa, Ayn, Lam. What haraka are we going to give the harf al-mudara'? We have a rule that says the harf al-mudara'a takes a fatha. We give it a fatha in all cases. Every single time you have a fi'l mudara', when you add the harf al-mudara'a, the harf al-mudara'a that you're adding, whether it's hamza, noon, ya, ta, is going to take a fatha. Except in one case, and that is if the fi'l has four letters. Unless the verb is four-lettered. If it's a four-lettered verb in the madi, which we haven't discussed, we haven't learnt, if it's a four-lettered verb, then the harf al-mudara takes a dhamma. That's the only time where you make the harf al-mudara take a dhamma, if it's a four-lettered verb. If it's three-lettered, five-lettered, six-lettered, then it's always going to take a fatha. But if it's a four-lettered verb, ruba'i, it takes a dhamma at the start. The harf al-mudara takes a dhamma. So we're dealing with three-lettered verbs. So our three-lettered verb starts with here. Fa, Ayn, Lam. We've added the extra ya. Then the ya takes a fatha. So that's step one. Add harful mudara. The harful mudara is going to take a fatha. Step two. This is a very easy step. Step two says that the fa is going to take a sukun. Step two is we give the fa ul kalima a sukun. Sukun on the fa ul kalima. Step three is the ayn. The ayn, we have three possibilities. It could either be fatha, kasra, or dhamma. The ayn may have a fatha, may have a kasra, or may have a dhamma. The three possibilities. Which one do we choose? This depends on the verb. It depends on the verb. You go back to the dictionary, or you go back to how the Arabs pronounce that particular verb. So for example, if it was dhahaba, for example, or fataha, with fataha, the Arabs said yaftahu, they gave the ainul kalima a fataha. So it's always going to have a fataha. If it's fataha yaftahu, it's never going to be fataha yaftihu or yaftuhu. It's going to be fataha yaftahu in all cases. With kharaja, they gave it a dhamma and said yakhruju, ruju. With daraba, they said yadribu. So in those three examples there, we have in the mudari' three different harakat on the ayn. We had yaftahu, yakhruju, and yadribu. So which of these to give depends on the verb. Depends on the verb. So we don't know. We don't know. But we should know that it's one of these three. It's not going to come out from these three. The ayn al-kalima is going to have a fatha, kasra, or dhamma. That's the Ainul Kalima. Now we're left with the Lamul Kalima, number four. The Lamul Kalima, we give it a Dhamma. We give it a Dhamma. So it's going to have a Dhamma. So it's either going to be Yaf'alu, Yaf'ilu, or Yaf'ulu. طيب, with the Dhamma on the Lam, we're giving it a Dhamma because the Fi'l Mudari is Mu'rab. The Madi is fixed. It's going to be fixed in all cases. It's either going to be fixed on Fatha, Dhahaba, Dhahabat. Fixed on Dhamma if it joins to a waw, the habu. Fixed on sukun if it's attached to a noon and anything else after noon. The habna, the habta, the habtuma, the habtum. Three possibilities. In all cases, it's fixed. Likewise, the fi'l amr is always fixed as well. It doesn't change. As for the fi'l mudari, then it's mu'rab. What does mu'rab mean? There's words that can come before it to influence its ending. It changes, affects its ending, and makes it take a Dhamma. And that Dhamma can turn into a fatha. And it can turn into a sukun. If it has a dhamma, it's marfu. In this case, we say this word is marfu. The fi'l mudari is marfu in this case. If it had a fatha, we say it's mansub. We don't have majrur in the fi'l mudari. In the af'al, majrur is something which is specific to nouns. It only enters nouns. So we don't have a fi'l mudari majrur any ever. So instead of majrur, we have another state, which is majzoom. Which we're going to learn. Majzoom is where it ends with a sukun. So if it's dhamma, marfu'. If it's fatha, mansub. Those two states, They are shared between the ism and the fi'l mudari'. They have that in common. But the difference is, majrur is something which is specific to the noun, just as majzoom, where it ends with the sukun, is specific to the fi'l mudari'. طيب. So we said we give it a dhamma. These are the four steps by which we arrive at the fi'l mudari'. So let's recap again. There's four steps to get the fi'l mudari'. You take the madi and you add one of the four letters which are called ahruful mudara'. And these ahruful mudara' have a meaning. The harful mudara' is going to have a fatha in all cases unless it's a four-lettered verb. If it's a four-lettered verb, you give the harful mudara' a dhamma. That's step one. Step two, the fa'ul kalima, you give it a sukoon. Step three, the ainul kalima could have one of three harakat. Fatha, kasra, dhamma depends on the verb. It depends on the verb that we're dealing with. We have to go back to the Arabs. We have to memorize something that you have to memorize. There's no rules to govern how to determine if it's fatha, kasra, dhamma. As for the last step, and that is the dhamma, we give it a dhamma in this case. So that's the four steps to create a fi'l mudari'. If we were to combine the possible scales from the madi with the possible scales from the mudari', we end up with six possible varieties. How is that? From fa'ala, we can get three possible mudari' forms. So it's either going to be fa'ala, yaf'alu, fa'ala, yaf'ilu, or fa'ala, yaf'ulu. From fa'ala, you see the ayn al-kalima, if it has a fatha in the mudari', it could possibly have a fatha, kasra, dhamma. طيب, look at the examples that we have. The examples that we've given here were chosen intentionally for that reason. So with fataha, fataha, yaftahu. That's the first one. Fataha, yaftahu is on the scale of fa'ala, yaf'alu. Kharaja is in the scale of kharaja, yakhruju, yaf'ulu. Kharaja, yakhruju, yaf'ulu. And the third possibility is daraba, daraba, yadribu, daraba, yadribu. So here we have one, two, three possible combinations from that. With fa'ila, we have two possibilities. Fa'ila, yaf'alu, or fa'ila, yaf'ilu. There's no dhamma here. So this would help you to determine if you knew that the madi was fa'ila, then you can eliminate the dhamma and assume that it's going to be one of these two, either yaf'il or yaf'alu. An example of that is here we have alima. Alima is on fa'ila. The mudari is ya'lamu. Alima ya'lamu. So it's on fa'ila yaf'alu. And then the other one we have hasiba. Hasiba. Hasiba is on fa'ila. Yahsibu. Hasiba yahsibu. Fa'ila yaf'ilu. So that gives us 3, 4, 5. That's 5. Then we have one more. With fa'ula, it only has one option, and that is yaf'ulu only. Example, karuma. Karuma yakrumu. Sharufa yashrufu. So here, if you had a fi'l madi that was on fa'ula, then you could eliminate these two and just say the fi'l mudari is going to have a dhamma on the ayn al-kalima and say it's on yaf'ulu. So we have six possible patterns or six possible combinations when we add the madi and the mudari for the thulathi, for the three-lettered verbs. Fa'ala yaf'alu, like fataha yaftahu. Fa'ala yaf'ilu, like daraba yadribu. Fa'ala yaf'ulu, like kharaja yakhruju. Fa'ila yaf'alu, like alima ya'lamu. Fa'ila yaf'ilu, like hasiba yahsibu. Fa'ula yaf'ulu, like karuma yakrumu. طيب. So this is how we create the fi'l mudari'. I hope that's understood. If that's understood, then we can begin reading. الدرس العاشر, the 10th lesson. ذهب زكريا لزيارة حامد بعد صلاة الفجر. زكريا is the فاعل here. We don't see the Dhamma because Zakariya is a word that ends with Alif. Any word that ends with Alif, we estimate the Haraka, the ending. So the Dhamma here is going to be estimated. It's Marfu, صح فاعل مرفوع, but the Dhamma is estimated. So ذهب زكريا, Zakariya went, لزيارتي, in order to visit Hamidin. So زيارتي is مضاف مضاف إليه. زكريا went to visit Hamid بعد صلاة الفجر, after صلاة الفجر. ولكنه ما وجده في البيت. However, he did not find him in the house. فقال لابنه موسى. So he said to his son موسى, أين أبوك? Where is your father? So لكن is from the sisters of إن. ها is اسم لكن. And then ما وجده في البيت, that جملة فعلية is coming as خبر لكن. فقال لابنه موسى. If someone asks you what's the Arab of موسى, we'd say موسى is the ibn. So this is بدل for ibn. This would be مجرور just like ibn, but we can't see it because it ends with alif. Mu'rab words which end with alif, they're changing in the end of these words. We can't see them because the alif is always sakin. The alif is vowelless at all times. So he said to him, أين أبوك? Where's your father? موسى replied, ذهب إلى السوق. He went to the market. زكريا أيذهب إلى السوق كل يوم? Does he go to the market every day? طيب, one of the things that we need to learn from this lesson is that the فعل مضارع, the tense of the فعل مضارع is present tense. And likewise, فعل مضارع is also used for something that a person does on a regular basis, which is why I said كل يوم. Does he go to the market every day? If you're asking a person, are you studying or do you study, you use the فعل مضارع. Whether they're doing it right now or if they do it regularly, you'd say أتدرس, do you study? أتدرس, are you studying right now? So here he used the فعل مضارع. And this فعل مضارع comes from ذهب. ذهب يذهب. So how did we get here? The first thing was to add the حرف مضارع. حرف مضارع, we have one of four letters to choose from. Hamza, Noon, Ya, Ta, Anaitu, Anaitu. He's chosen Ya because Ya is for the third person. He's speaking about someone. He's speaking about Hamid, who's not in the conversation. So he's asking his son Musa about his father. So Ya is the most appropriate one to choose from the four of those letters. Yadhabu, he went. Yadhabu, not he went, but he is going or he goes. Thal, which is the fa'ul kalima, takes a sukun. In this case, yadhhabu, we know the ayinul kalima takes a fatha because dhahaba yadhhabu comes on the scale of fa'ala yaf'alu. How did we know that? We just have to memorize that. There's no way of determining whether it comes on yaf'alu, yaf'ilu, yaf'ulu, as we mentioned. We just have to memorize. So with dhahaba, it's yadhhabu. It's never going to be yadhhibu or yadhhubu. That's wrong, yeah? Yadhhabu, so it's fa'ala yaf'alu. أَيَذْهَبُ, does he go إلى السوق كل يوم, every day? If you remember, we mentioned about the اسم الإشارة. اسم الإشارة, if it comes before a ظرف, the اسم الإشارة takes the place of the ظرف, and then the ظرف comes either as بدل or something else. طيب, likewise, we apply the same rule with كل. كل, if كل comes before a ظرف, the كل is going to take the place of the ظرف. That's why it's منصوب. The dharf is mansub, so that's why this is mansub. And then this word is always mudaf. So it becomes mansub, wa huwa mudaf, and then the mudaf ilayhi, the actual dharf, becomes mudaf ilayhi. So does he go to the market every day? Musa says, na'am. Yadhhabu da'iman. Da'iman means always. Yadhhabu da'iman. He always goes. Ila suqi ba'da salat al-fajr. After salat al-fajr. He always goes to the market after Salat al-Fajr. Zakariya, mata yarji'u min as-suqi? When does he return from the market? Likewise, the same way that he goes on a regular basis, he returns on a regular basis. So he's using the fi'l mudari once again. So he didn't use mata raja'a, when did he return? It's not something that he went and he returned one time. He goes every time, so he must return every time. So that's why he's using the mudari once again. And this is on the scale of يَفْعِيلُ. فَعَلَ رَجَعَ يَرْجِعُ يَفْعِيلُ. So you have to memorize this. رَجَعَ يَرْجِعُ. This is how it's going to be in the مضارع. You just have to memorize this. مَتَى يَرْجِعُ مِنَ السُّوق. When does he return from the market? Musa. يَرْجِعُ. He returns فِي السَّاعَةِ السَّابِعَةِ. At 7 o'clock. That's how we translate السَّاعَةِ السَّابِعَةِ. Even though literally it means 7th hour. In the 7th hour, that's when he returns. Because these are ordinal numbers. But in English, we are going to say he returns at 7 o'clock. وَأَحْيَانًا. And sometimes. So دائماً is always. أَحْيَانًا sometimes. So he returns at 7 o'clock. وَأَحْيَانًا. And sometimes فِي السَّاعَةِ الثَّامِنَةِ at 8 o'clock. 8 o'clock, 7 o'clock. This is نَعْت مَنْعُوت. It's coming as نَعْت مَنْعُوت. زكريا. مَاذَا يَفْعَلُ فِي الْبَيْتِ. What does he do in the house? ماذا يفعل? What does he do in the house? So even though فعل يفعل, we use it to weigh the different verbs. It's a standard, it's the mizan, it's the scale that we use. It actually has a meaning. فعل means to do something. فعل is a فعل. فعل means he did. The مضارع of فعل is يفعل. فعل يفعل. طيب, it actually has its own meaning, and that is to do something. What does he do in this case? ماذا يفعل في البيت? What does he do in the house? Musa says, يقرأ الصحف. He reads newspapers. يقرأ الصحف. This is something which he does regularly after returning, or يعني while he's in the house. يقرأ الصحف. He reads newspapers. ويسمع الأخبار. And he listens to the news. من الإذاعة, from the radio station. He reads newspapers and he listens to the news from the radio station. Zakaria. متى يذهب إلى المصنع? متى يذهب إلى المصنع? When does he go to the factory? مصنع is factory. مصنع factory. موسى says, يذهب في الساعة التاسعة والنصف. يذهب في الساعة التاسعة والنصف. He goes at 9:30. 9:30 or 9:30. Zakaria. ومتى يرجع من هناك? So النصف is معطوف to التاسعة. So this is مجرور. This is going to be مجرور also. Zakaria. ومتى يرجع من هناك? And when does he return from there? When does he return from the factory? موسى says, يرجع في الساعة الواحدة والنصف. أو الثانية. يرجع, he returns في الساعة الواحدة at 1 o'clock, so midday, lunch time. والنصف, 1:30. He returns at 1:30. أو الثانية, or at 2 o'clock. أو is also a harf atf, just like wow. So this is a harf atf also. والنصف أو الثانية. الثانية is معطوف to الواحدة, just like والنصف is معطوف to الواحدة. So he returns at 1:30 or 2 o'clock. Zakaria, أيذهب إلى المصنع مرة أخرى بعد الظهر. أيذهب إلى المصنع. Does he go to the factory مرة أخرى? Another time. مرة is يعني once. مرة أخرى, on another occasion. بعد الظهر, after ظهر. So he turns after ظهر. He's asking, does he return back to the factory after ظهر? Musa says, لا, no, لا يذهب بعد الظهر. He does not go after ظهر. لا يذهب بعد ظهر. He does not go after ظهر. يجلس هنا في مكتبه بعد صلاة العصر. يجلس هنا. He sits here. في مكتب. مكتب is office. مكتبه is library. This is مكتبه, in his office after صلاة العصر. So here we have a fi'l mudari, which is yajlisu, is on yaf'ilu. The madi is fa'ala. So if you were to ask what pattern is this on, what combination? Fa'ala yaf'ilu. Jalasa yajlisu. You have to memorize that. Zakaria. Kam amilan ya'malu fi masna'ikum. How many workers? Amil is worker. Kam amilan ya'malu. So ya'malu is work, to do work. The madi is amila. Amila ya'malu. عمل يعمل فعل يفعل في مصنعكم. So now if we get a fi'l, we need to memorize its madi and its mudari. طيب, if it's a ثلاثي three-letter verb, we have to memorize its pattern in the madi and its pattern in the mudari. This is what we have to do for all of the verbs. كم عاملا, how many workers, يعمل, who work في مصنعكم, in your factory. موسى, مصنعنا ليس بكبير. Our factory is not big. So ليس is from the sisters of كان. From the sisters of كان. It enters upon a جملة اسمية. ليس enters upon a جملة اسمية. What is the جملة اسمية if we was to talk about ليس بكبير? ليس has entered upon a جملة اسمية. Where is the جملة اسمية? The original جملة would have been هو كبير. هو, going back to the مصنع, the factory. هو كبير. ليس has entered. What happens to هو? هو reverts into ضمير متصل. Remember, this is a verb. So how do you represent هو as a ضمير that's attached to a verb? It's not visible. It's going to be hidden. So ليس, اسم ليس is hidden. اسم ليس ضمير مستتر is the hidden ضمير, which is هو, going back to the مصنع. And then we have here the حرف الجر الزائد, and كبير is مجرور لفظا, but is actually منصوب. It's supposed to be ليس كبيرا. Remember, ليس and كان and sisters, they make the اسم مرفوع and the خبر منصوب. So كبيرا is اسم ليس is supposed to be, but because of با it becomes بكبير. So our factory is not big. If we was to analyze the full sentence, this full sentence here, مصنع is مبتدأ وهو مضاف مضاف إليه. And where's the خبر for مصنع? The خبر for مصنع is the جملة فعلية, starting from ليس, the جملة فعلية. يعمل فيه 125 عاملا ومهندسان. يعمل فيه, يعني how many people work in it was the question. So he said our factory is a small factory. يعمل فيه, the workers who work in it are 125. So 100, 25 is 25. 25 is 25. عاملا ومهندسان. So there's 125 workers and two engineers. 125 workers and two engineers. طيب, so this is a fi'l mudari. Ya'malu. We said amila ya'malu. That's why he's taken off the harakat, because he's expecting you already to know that this is ya'malu. Ya'malu, where's the fa'il for ya'malu? Ya'malu, mi'atun is the fa'il. Mi'atun is fa'il. Wa khamsatun is ma'atuf. Wa ashurun is ma'atuf also. So some of the numbers, yani especially these ones here, they are ma'tuf, like from 21, 22, we'd say wahidun wa ishroon, wa ithnani wa ishroon, thalathatun wa ishroon. When you want to say 21, 22, 23, you bring a waw, harf atf, between the numbers. Likewise 31, 32, all the way to 99. And likewise, if you want to join these numbers to 100, you would add 125, you add the waw in between as well. So it's going to carry the hukum. If this was mi'atin, it would be wa khamsatin wa ishirina. It carries the hukum. This is marfu', so this becomes marfu', and then this becomes marfu' also. So all of them are marfu', because the first one is marfu', it's ma'tuf to this one. So 125 workers, wa muhandisani, and two engineers. Zakaria, as-sa'atu al-ana at-tasi'atu illa rub'an. The time, as-sa'a can mean hour, and it can also mean time generally. So the time right now is at-tasi'a illa rub'an. It's 9 except a quarter. So quarter to 9. It's quarter to 9. At-tasi'atu illa rub'an, quarter to 9. Illa, it comes for exception. Yani use it to make an exception. So the time is 9. Except that there's a quarter of an hour left. In this type of setup, the word that's going to come after illa is going to be mansub, rub'an. If wanted to say illa thuluthan, like what we learnt previously, that 20 minutes is a third of an hour, right? So 22:09 would say atasi'atu illa thuluthan. If it was a half, we'd say atasi'atu illa nisfan, except a half an hour. So in this type of setup, the thing that comes after illa, whatever you apply an exception to, becomes mansub. So the time right now is 8:45. وَمَا رَجَعَ أَبُوكَ, and your father has not returned. Your father has not returned. Meaning, because he mentioned at the start that he comes back around 7 or 8 from Fajr, and then he goes to the factory, right? What time does he go to the factory? He mentions here that يَذْهَبُ فِي السَّاعَةِ التَّاسِعَ وَالنِّصْفِ. He goes at 9:30 to the factory, but he hasn't even returned yet from the market. So that's why he said now it's 8:45 and your father hasn't even returned yet. طيب, so Musa says لَعَلَّهُ يَرْجِعُ الْيَوْمَ مُتَأَخِّرًا. لَعَلَّهُ, I am afraid that he's going to come return today late. مُتَأَخِّرًا, late. طيب, بَارَكَ اللَّهُ فِيكُمْ. That was the passage. In terms of homework, if we can answer أَجِبًا لِلْأَسْئِلَةِ الْآتِيَةِ تأمل الأمثلة الآتية. Okay, let's do the first two exercises as homework. أجب عن الأسئلة الآتية and صحح ما يلي. بارك الله فيكم. سبحانك اللهم وبحمدك, أشهد أن لا إله إلا أنت, أستغفرك وأتوب إليك.